Hello, all you overblooders out there. This is Walter 80, and I'm going to be introducing you to my Diablo 2 Ultra Replay that I'm starting to set up here. This little introductory video will be to pretty much confirm that I am serious about doing this. Also, to show you how to set up Diablo 2 to work effectively on newer Windows operating systems. Diablo 2 is a very old program, and it works great on Windows 98. However, these newer ones, for some reason, it's a little bit unstable, and Blizzard doesn't feel the need to, patch it to make it work on these, which I'm pretty sure with some simple patches it would probably be able to do. But that's irrelevant, which is actually kind of surprising, because Blizzard has patched the game within the last couple of years, adding a few new features to it. But that's a tangent. Right now I'm going to show you a few tricks that you will need to do to get Diablo 2 to run as smoothly as possible on your new Windows operating system. Also, let it be known that Clint did ask me earlier, I'm sorry, I have the hiccups right now, so if you hear some weird stuff on the mic, that's what it is. Clint did ask me earlier if Diablo 2 works with the Mac operating system, and first of all, I want to apologize to anybody that uses Macs, because I'm, just very, very sorry for you. But looking here on any of the Diablo 2 boxes, it will say that it does work with Macintosh. The only thing is, like I said, with the newer Windows operating systems, there are some instability issues that we're going to work on fixing here. So I don't know if there will be those with the Macs or not, but if you do own a Mac, either go and buy a Windows computer and you'll be a lot better off, or I guess look it up on Safari or whatever it is you people use. But I'm going to show you how us normal people tweak Diablo 2 to get it to work for us. Here is Diablo 2. Already installed. Nothing about installing it has issues with the newer systems. But this is going to be the simplest and most basic thing you'll need to do, and it's practically required, otherwise you won't even get Diablo 2 to launch. So we're going to right-click it, and we're going to go to Properties, and in our Properties here, we want to go to Compatibility Mode. First of all, right here, just so everybody knows, in the target area here, game and windowed mode, you can type W like that, and that will get the game to run windowed mode. I know a lot of people prefer playing the game that way. It'll play at the native resolution. It might look a little better on your computer. You can't tell this, just from the recording software, but this is actually a 28-inch monitor I'm on right here, and its resolution right now is 1920 by 1200. Diablo 2 runs at, something like 900 by 800 or something like that, so there is a huge, huge difference in resolution, and it looks a little fuzzy on my monitor, but if you want to play it in windowed mode, you can alleviate that. I still like full screen. I'm just weird like that. Okay, we want the compatibility tab, though. This stuff is required to run Diablo 2. What you're going to do is, first and foremost, run this program in compatibility mode for Windows XP Service Pack 3. Obviously, if you are using Windows XP and you have Service Pack 3 installed, you're good to go. If you're not, why are you using Windows XP without installing Service Pack 3? Otherwise, if you have Vista or Windows 7, which is what I'm using here, so if anybody using Vista says, hey, this looks different from what I'm used to, this is Windows 7, but it works the same way. You want to run it in compatibility mode, you want to disable desktop composition, and you want to run this program as an administrator. Once all those things are set up, click Apply, and you're done with that screen. I don't really want Diablo 2 icon there, I was just showing you it's already installed. Alright, the next trick we're going to need to do, rolling right along, is open our friend Task Manager. If you don't know how to do that, I don't even know why you own a computer, but that's Control-Delete, and then you select Task Manager. You want to be in the Services tab. There's many tabs up here. Make sure you're in the one that says Services. Then we want to go down to the very bottom where you see this button that says Services. Click it. We are going to look for a service called Windows Media Player, what is it called? Windows Media Player something. Windows Media Center. No, Windows Media Player Network Sharing Service. There we go. You want this to be disabled. Obviously, if you use Windows Media Player a lot, then that may be something that you want to re-enable when you're done playing Diablo 2. But until then, disable it while Diablo 2 is playing. This addresses some serious lag spike arise due to the game's instability with the new Windows. I don't understand why disabling Windows Media Player Network Sharing Service does this, but it does, especially when playing online. Okay, so that's that. And one last tweak that is also necessary to achieve the smoothest performance as possible is to go to your My Computer, go to wherever you have your Diablo 2 game files, and after you've installed it, there will be one here called the Diablo 2 Vid Test. Go ahead and open that up. You can run the test if you want, but that's just a waste of time and creates a lot of screen blanking, so I'm just going to skip the test. And you're presented with two options. You can either run the game in direct draw, or you can run the game in direct 3D. I strongly recommend direct draw because it will make the game a lot smoother. Now, however, there is a mode, if you choose to allow the game to be rendered in direct 3D, that will allow you to choose perspective in the graphics options of the game. And what this will do is it creates a strange mode 7 effect that adds a slight degree of 3D-ness to the game. And it looks cool, but it does cause some slight slowdown issues, and it looks a little blurry, honestly, too. So for the sharpest, smoothest gaming experience, run the game using direct draw. Now, if you do choose to render in direct 3D, there is an option that you can disable the perspective if you want to do that, but note that the game is still being rendered by direct 3D, which is just a little bit slower with Diablo 2 for some reason. So go ahead and set it up like that. Okay, so those are all the tweaks we need to do. Lastly, I will just be showing you a bit of gameplay, so for anybody who is on the fence about whether or not they wish to purchase Diablo 2, they can see what it looks like and see whether or not they wish to participate in my Ultra Replay. I think it's going to be a lot of fun, guys, and we're going to have a pretty...
Okay, as promised, here is some Diablo 2 gameplay. And this is actually my second attempt at recording this, because in my first recording, I was droning a little bit, and it was boring even for me to listen to while I was previewing it to post it. So hopefully this one is a little less monotonous, and not a complete pain in the ass to listen to. I'm just going to jump in on a character I have already created and spent a little bit of time in the game with. This is not going to be the character I'm using for the actual game. This is merely somebody I've just, like I said, spent a little time with. Just to kind of get some of the basic stuff out of the way, and show you what the gameplay looks like, so that, so you can check it out and see, so you can make an informed decision. I'm just going to jump right into some action. You can check it out. We'll go to the Dark Wood. And I'm going to get a shield. The shields are good. I'm going to use my mini-map. My current quest is to explore the cellar dungeons beneath the Tower Ruins. The tower is over here on this part of my mini-map that isn't very mini. And that's where I'm going to head. And I'm not going to do too much or get too far, because this isn't, this isn't about me playing Diablo. This is about the community Overblood experience. Us playing this classic game. That's unusually rare to get two gemstones in a row like that. That was a boss, but I just killed him very easily because I kind of pwn. Anyways, like I said, this isn't about me playing Diablo 2. This is going to be about the entire Overblood experience, and having everybody involved and joining this epic quest to kill Diablo and his three brothers. No, Diablo and his two brothers. There are three total brothers. I wonder what their last name is. Diablo is the Lord of Destruction. Mephisto is the Lord of Hatred, and Baal. No, Baal's the Lord of Destruction, Diablo's the Lord of Fear. Their last name is maybe Devil, Diablo Devil, I don't know, Baal Devil. I have no idea what their last name is. Maybe it's just Smith, Diablo Smith. I'm in the Black Marsh, killing these guys, these people, giving them a good talking to, good smackdown. And over here is more people. This is a point-and-click game, ladies and gentlemen. So you'll be doing a lot of pointing and clicking. Hope that doesn't frustrate or aggravate you, because the gameplay is quite addicting here, actually. I have been informed by my avatar that this place I'm in holds many secrets. Oh, God. There were some secrets right there. They were just waiting for me. They were actually camping right here in this camp spot, waiting for somebody to come down these stairs. And they were going to try and kill them, but cheaters never prosper. Camping doesn't get you anywhere, and in fact, it gets you dead, as you can plainly see. Like I said, I'm not going to get too far into this, because I want to ruin any of the secrets that are contained within this dungeon, or any of the surprises, or anything. This is just showing you some of the gameplay, so anyone on the fence about whether or not they want to purchase this game can now make an informed decision. And I hope to see as many of y'all as possible on the community ultra replay of Diablo 2. By the way, the reason I'm calling it ultra replay is because we are not just going to do the game on one playthrough. I want to try and do all three playthroughs of the game. I want to see if it brings that option up here for you. To make a name, okay. Oh, it didn't ask me to select difficulty. I wanted to show you that there were three difficulties. But in either case, there are three. There's normal, then there's nightmare, and then there's hell. Each difficulty gets progressively more difficult. You use your same character through it, so the level cap is 99 in this game, so you can get pretty darn powerful, but the enemies get very powerful too, and actually, new items and weapons become available the higher up in the difficulties you go, so it's not exactly the same experience each time. Plus, all of the maps are randomly generated, so you don't even follow the same path each time. Sorry, I have hiccups there. So it's pretty cool going all the way up through all the difficulty levels. Your strategies have to change. You know, enemies start to become immune to certain types of magic or physical attacks, and they even have different attacks they use themselves. So it gets pretty tough, very, very challenging in Hell Mode, but it should be lots of fun and a pretty interesting adventure for all those who wish to join. That's all for right now, and I'll see you on next time.